So art is the expression of a man's feelings and imagination on through a medium. When both are given a form, it is called art. Artist has a total freedom to deny reality because they are supposed to be the creator of beauty. There is no limitation and no restriction for creating beauty. There is one quote by a poem. There is a quote famous for a poet that "Jaan pahunche ravi, tyan pahunche kavi." So aesthetic is a discipline in which authors and philosophers try to explain the concept of beauty. Bharat was the first to write aesthetic in Natya Shastram, and Oriental art and Oriental aesthetics are terms which are used to design it all art. Next slide, sir. Next, yes. Most Indian art can be given a religious interpretation by a person of strongly theistic inclination. Religious and philosophic thought is quite significant as a factor in the social context of art in any moment of history. The development of religion was accomplished by a corresponding growth in vivid imaginary. Much Indian art and criticism had religious form and content. This is evident from the link that one can make between the Rasleela of Krishna and the Gopis and the Rasa theory. The first theory which I'm going to discuss here is Dhvani theory. The Dhvani Siddhant is also known as a theory of suggestion. This word means sound literally, but does not deal with the function of sound in the musical sense. Dhvani theory is propounded by Anandvardhan in the 9th century. He gives this theory in Dhvanyalok. The Dhvani theory considers the indirectly evoked meaning of suggestivity as a characteristic feature of literary utterance. Next slide, sir. According to Anandvardhan, the soul of Kavya is Dhvani. Anandvardhan believes that Dhvani is the main part of poem. In his work Dhvanyalok, he has given a detailed description of structural analysis of indirect meanings. Dhvani was initially written for poetry, but by the time it's used in the art also for its suggestive meaning. And the significance of this theory for all art forms lie in the fact that visual art also communicates through suggestion and can suggest both meaning and emotion. Next. So another theory was Alankara Siddhant. Alankara Siddhant, also known as the theory of figures. The founder of Alankara theory is Palma. Palma gave this theory in 6th century. He defines Kavya as a togetherness of sound and meaning. According to Palma, Alankara means poetic figure is the essential element of poetry, and it consists in the striking manner of putting a striking idea in all actually striking words. And Alankara is used to underline and integral part of literal meaning. Anandvardhana views in Dhvanyalok that Alankaras are those elements which, depending upon word and meaning, minister to the generation of poetic charm. It is also certifies the creative use of language in literature. Another theory is the Riti theory. The Riti theory was founded by Vaman in the 19th century. Kavyalankar Sutravruti is a work of Vaman, and in which, in this work, he discusses about the Riti theory. The basic meaning of Riti is style, the method, and according to Vaman, Riti or mode of expression constitutes the soul of poetry. Two other words used for Riti are marg and vritti. There is a three type of style of Riti. The first is Vaidarbhi. The second is Gaudi. Vaman takes the Vaidarbhi style as the best style of a poem. He says that it is properly balanced in Vaidarbhi style. And Klesh, Samta, Samadhi, Marg, to observe and Vyakti and Kanti. These are the 10 qualities which fulfill in Vaidarbhi style. The next the second one theory of Indian aesthetic is Aucitya theory. This Siddhant is also known as theory of propriety, and Kshemendra made Aucitya the central element of poetry. The theory of propriety claims that in all aspect of literary composition, and there is a possibility of a perfect, the most appreciate choice of a subject, of idea, of word, or of device. And it has been used for a property in it has been used for a property in delineating poems according to the speaker, content, and type of literary composition. Next slide. Aucitya Vichar Charcha is the work of Kshemendra, and in which in this work he talks about this theory. And Kshemendra, he also highlights the concept that can extend without much modification on the various art forms. In simple words, we can see that there must be a fit between themes and forms, and this is so in all aesthetic fields. The next slide. The last one theory is a Vakrokti theory. This Vakrokti Siddhant is also known as the theory of oblique expression. The founder of Vakrokti theory is Kuntak. Kuntak was a Kashmiri Sanskrit poetician and a literary theorist who is remembered for his work Vakrokti Jivita, in which he postulated and he postulated the Vakrokti Siddhanta, or theory of oblique expression. In this theory, Kuntak wants to convey that certain strikingness of expression is a essence of poetry. Next slide.